Hi everyone, welcome to another edition of Dan's Diary. I thought, given yesterday the post-race biffo, I mean, how could you not ask the riders at the tour for reaction and get their opinion on what they thought about the biffo? Is it good for the sport? And what would they do in a similar situation? Matty White, now we've talked over a couple of years about bringing the biff back into the sprints and all that sort of stuff, but I think the tour was taken to another level yesterday. Did you see the footage of Brado and Costa at the finish line?
I did actually, and you know, it's sometimes it can be seen as a negative thing, but I actually quite enjoyed it actually.
Bringing back the biff, I think it's brilliant. I mean, people say, oh, it's bad for the publicity. I think it's huge for the publicity. People watching aggressive people with the finish of events, pulling out your wheel and just throwing it at someone.
Bit of a handbag fight.
Oh yeah, so a bit of an open-handed slap at one stage there. If it had been yourself, I mean, how would have you gone about it? Would have you used a front wheel or maybe pistol whip with a chain ring? What would have been your attack?
No, I consider myself very professional, and there's a time and a place for everything, and after the finish in front of the world's media is probably not the place you'd do anything of that sort of nature.
Yeah, you don't see too much of it, or probably don't see enough of it in this sport, so two little hill climbers going at it was quite funny. They could have jabbed in a better sort of straight punch instead of getting a wheel, you know.
In your career, mate, have you ever belted another rider or come close to going the biffo on the bike?
Not on the bike, but after the finish, I've had a couple of words, and not so much scuffing, but yeah, I haven't actually hit anyone on the bike, no.
People were watching Brado, because you can see his blue jersey. On the way down, Costa gives it the old diamond cutter.
The old Hulk Hogan.
Yeah, the old diamond cutter on the way down. And that's why he was bleeding, and everyone thought it was boxing. There was no boxing skills involved.
That was just WWE.
Yeah, it was pure just get amongst it sort of style. I found it brilliant, to be honest. Yeah.
Now, being a massive, intimidating unit like yourself, have you been in many altercations among the riders? Do you throw your weight around?
Yeah, I frequently have blues in the peloton.
Yeah.
And it's seldom that anyone wants to take me on, purely because of my size.
Do you find early in your career it's good to do that so that they know, oh, that Matty Lloyd, don't touch him?
Step off. Don't even touch it.
Have you ever been in a biffo in the race before or with other riders on the bike?
Yeah, not for some years. Tend to cool down a bit since I got older, not like I was when I was younger, but not for some years.
Is there any riders in the peloton that you know have got a short fuse and they could snap at any moment that you simply wouldn't want to get in a biffo situation with? Who's probably the most intimidating?
I don't know. Dave Zabriskie? I don't think so.
If you couldn't hear, he just said he'd tear your face off. So.
That's WWF talk. No, not really. Just try and play it cool most of the time. And, you know, anyone can get irate at any time. You know, the heat's always on, the pressure's on, and guys are nervous. So.
Now, we spoke to you last year about the crowds, and you said you've given a bloke a jab for pinching your sunnies. Have you ever had a run-in with a rider?
Not really. Once my teammate was in a bit of a tussle after finishing a small race in France, and I come flying in and actually slipped over on my bike shoes before I got there, so I picked my bike up and walked away, so it wasn't much action there.
Now, if it was called on and you did have to pull the gloves out, would you use a wheel or would you use something else at the finish line?
Nah, if it was another cyclist, I'd definitely just use the old fist. But the wheel, that's a beauty, you know. He's come back from a tussle before and come out of the crowd flying. I saw that, and it was quite entertaining to watch on YouTube last night.
Now, I think the fine was 400 Swiss francs. Do you think he got off lightly in the end? Because in AFL circles, I mean, you're looking at about 8 weeks.
No, I really think they did get off pretty well. If those guys got thrown off the race yesterday, I wouldn't have been surprised. I think it was actually an ongoing bit of a skit. They had actually fought in the race, and then they had words, and I heard that the Kazdapan rider actually split the Quickstep guy's lip after they crossed the finish line, and that's all we saw on YouTube was
their reaction,
you know. But it was a pretty good reaction, I think.
Well, we'll see how we go, mate.
Yeah, I bet he spiced it up a bit, I reckon.
Now, how are these two going to go on the peloton? Because, I mean, you guys all talk amongst yourselves. Do you reckon they're going to be a butt of a few jokes, or will they get, like, legendary status?
I mean, it's probably not that good for the sport, really. The organisations won't like it, but we'll call him Rocky or whatever you want to call him today, so it'll be quite funny.
Big mountain sage today, mate. What's the plan? Just take a few out with the elbows early on and then try and clear the path for a stage win?
I mean, in reality, I think it'd be smarter to pull out my wheel and just hit him on the start line.
Yeah.
From a sporting perspective, I'm opting for the riding sort of perspective, which should be all right. I'm feeling okay. I
mean, it's a bit boring doing it by the book, though.
You just got to do it. You know, it's part of being a professional athlete.
Oh, well, good luck, mate, with the professional etiquette.
Okay, I'll maintain that frame of mind. Thanks.